I truly believe challenges can be overcome by education, dedication, innovation, and perspiration.
Oakland County is such a great place to live because it's a wonderful community. You can definitely feel the support that people have for education in our area, that they have for professionalism, that they have for business and entrepreneurs. It's just a place where the energy is cultivated and people can grow and prosper. It's been an honor to be living in Oakland County for the majority of my life. My job as a teacher helps prepare students for this knowledge-based economy. Technology in a classroom motivates students beyond anything else that I've seen. They want to be able to utilize it and to help them get to that next level of learning. But it's just important because that is the future. In any job that they'll have, they'll need to be able to use technology and create technology. I see many different career paths for students in Oakland County because there are so many opportunities and there are many different avenues for kids to explore those before they get to college so that they can really find their passion. You know, being a teacher in Oakland County is so helpful in this transition because our community really values education and has really seen the need for change and for growth. It's really exciting just to see what their future will hold, and I don't think you can get that in many other professions. My name is Melody Arabu, and I'm honored to be the 2015 Oakland County Elite 40 Under 40 winner.
Thank you. It is a true honor to represent the extraordinary 2015 class of the Elite 40 Under 40. The combined caliber of skill, passion, and professionalism in this room represents the best of Oakland County. I'd like to acknowledge my fellow finalists, Andrew Shemaluski and Luke Fleer, whose warmth and kindness match their incredible talent and dedication. In the coming year, I have the privilege to be an ambassador for the vision L. Brooks Patterson has for Oakland County. I have lived here for the majority of my life, and I have planted the roots for my family's next generation. The 22 years of Brooks's leadership and commitment to excellence make me proud to call Oakland County home. Oakland County is home to my parents, who emigrated from Iraq and worked tirelessly to move here to give their five kids everything this area has to offer. It is home to my three children, where my 8-year-old daughter and 5-year-old twin boys can appreciate safety, value diversity, and flourish in endless opportunities for their future. Oakland County is home to my husband's business, where for over 18 years, he has prospered in the heart of downtown Royal Oak. It is home to the Wald Lake School District, where I've spent the last 13 years connecting with kids and learning from education's best and most inspiring leaders. Brooks's initiatives will impact Oakland County for decades to come. It is a place that people strive to attain to fulfill their hopes and dreams, a place that has a national reputation of excellence in fiscal management, a place that offers knowledge-based careers that raise our standard of living. Oakland County is a place that embraces technology to improve transparency and provide better customer service. A place that promotes healthy and active lifestyles to improve our quality of life. Oakland County is all of this and more because of one man, a visionary of strength, growth, and innovation. A man that has developed a great place to live, work, play, and raise a family. A place we are all proud to call home. Please join me in welcoming Oakland County Executive L. Brooks Patterson.
Thank you.
Please. Thank you very much.
Thanks, John. 11C. Good evening, everybody. As I made my way to the dais tonight just then, and as I sit here now, the question on many of your minds may well be, how is my recovery going? Well, it's going just fine, thank you. The good news is, I don't fall down anymore. The bad news is, I do perform random gravity checks. I go to physical therapy 3 days a week. Every session, my trainer wants me to warm up by touching my toes. And I tell him every day, if I'm there, if God wanted me to touch my toes, he would have put them on my knees, so. Melody, that was a great introduction. Thank you so much for your very kind words. Melody is the winner, as you just heard, of the 40 under 40 class, fourth class of the 40 under 40 elite. Really, these are some of Oakland County's finest and most accomplished young men and women who are already making contributions to the quality of life within their communities. I'm delightful to have Ben Emp join me tonight for my 2015 State of the County Address. Will the 40 under 40 honorees who are here tonight from all four classes please stand and be recognized? Please stand. Thank you. Yeah, 2014, it was a busy and productive year. We reached a preliminary agreement on the formation of a regional water authority after 40 years. Our finances continue to shine. And tonight you will hear about milestones we've reached in some of our marquee initiatives as we continue to set the bar high as your county government. First, tonight, let's go to the big news. Tomorrow, my staff will deliver a resolution to the Board of Commissioners asking them to reduce the county's tax rate by 0.10 mils for the July 2015 tax levy and an additional 0.05 mils for the July 2016 levy. Now, to put those reductions in dollars and cents, the taxpayers of Oakland County, that's you will save $75 million over the next 10 years. That $75 million back into your pockets for you to use as you see fit. It will stimulate the local economy and it will contribute to a stronger quality of life here in Oakland County. Now, how can we do this when other governments are struggling? You've heard me say it time and time again at my State of the County addresses. We exercise thoughtful management, not crisis management. Oakland County adopts a long-term view, the long-range vision, and then has the patience and the discipline to get there. Our countywide elected officials are all on board working cooperatively with us to help manage the cost. And to the county employees, thank you for your hard work, dedication, positive attitude, and sacrifices that helped us achieve our financial goals. It is the work of the entire Oakland County team that allows me tonight to announce this tax reduction. Some additional financial highlights. We are still the only AAA-rated county in America with a three-year rolling budget, line item budget, and it incorporates as well a five-year outlook. Right now, even factoring in the proposed millage reduction, listen to this, that I've just announced, I am pleased to tell you that our budget is balanced through the year 2020. In other words, Oakland County's budget is balanced through the year that Jeb Bush will be seeking his second term. Where else but in the United States, maybe in the world, can you find a government with a balanced budget through 2020? Our strong financial position allows me to move forward on some delayed capital improvement programs and security upgrades that we had postponed during the Great Recession. Those are expenditures which must be addressed sooner than later. And remember Oakland County's so-called legacy costs, those pesky health care and pension obligations? Well, they're completely funded. And this past spring, we completed the refinancing of our health care certificates of participation with lower interest rate bonds. The savings, $13 million annually. That's over $170 million for the 13-year life of the bonds. And after those bonds are paid off, we save $34 million a year going forward. It's simply the best of all outcomes. We save taxpayers' money, we keep the promises made to our employees in exchange for their lifetime of work, and we free up resources to meet future challenges and needs. Our employees have migrated to a defined contribution retirement plan. That's like a 401k, leaving behind the older defined benefit pension plan with lifetime health care costs. That move alone has saved my taxpayers far north of $100 million. All of these moves in disciplined, patient financial planning allows us today the ability to reduce your property taxes. And I ask all the commissioners to support my proposal, whether you're on which side of the aisle. Together we have shown that we are good stewards of the taxpayers' money. So let's demonstrate that again by reducing taxes when we can.